A very good morning, class. We are in the chapter number 1 of civics, how we run our villages. We have already seen about the local self-government, how does it form, what are the powers bestowed to him. What is Panchayati Raj and what are the divisions of Panchayati Raj, how are the panchayats divided or sub-categorized. Today we will see how are panchayats formed. How are panchayats formed? See, basically the criteria or the division of the panchayat is at three level. The district level, it is referred as Jila Parishad. At district level it is referred as Jila Parishad. At block level it is referred as Block Samiti or Panchayat Samiti. And at village level, it is referred as Gram Panchayat. Gram Panchayat at village level. So these are the three basic divisions of, or you can say the structure of Panchayati Raj in our country, how the panchayats are distributed. Jila Parishad at district level, block or panchayat samiti at block level, and Gram Panchayat at village level. Now, what are the heads of these organizations known at different levels? At Jila Parishad, which is maintained at district level, the person who manages or who is owns the post is known as DM, that is district magistrate. DM or district magistrate. At the block level, the person is referred as BDO. BDO, that is block development officer. Block development officer. And at the Gram Panchayat level, the person is called as Panchayat Secretary. Panchayat Secretary. Panchayat Secretary. So these are three levels. The basic structure of Panchayati Raj. Structure of Panchayati Raj in our country. This is the basic structure of Panchayati Raj in our country. At Jila Parishad or at district level, the person who owns is known as DM, district magistrate. At block or the Panchayat Samiti, at block level is called as BDO, block development officer. And at the village level, Gram Panchayat is known as Panchayat Secretary. Panchayat Secretary. So this is the structure of Panchayati Raj in our country. Today we'll talk about how are panchayats formed. How are the panchayats formed? The panchayats at the three levels are formed by members who are elected by the people. It is the people who elect. We have the right to vote. We live in a democratic country. Every one of us is bestowed with the right. We have the voting powers. We can cast our vote, we can elect our own rulers, our own leaders. So this right, basically a right to exercise, is given by the government, is given by the constitution. For panchayat election, the area under the panchayat is divided into smaller areas called as constituencies or wards. For panchayat election, the area is subcategorized into smaller areas, which is known as constituency or ward. The members are elected for a term of 5 years. This is a general platform, or this is a general performa that we follow in our country. From a panchayat election to a prime minister election, every member is given the right to be elected for a term of 5 years. Some seats are reserved. This is the general reservation that has been given by the constitution to some economically backward groups or some people who could not match up with the pace of the developed people. For them, a reservation category has come, on the basis of which the reservation system is there. And people basically from ST, scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, other backward classes and the women are given special preferences so that they can come into the main ambit of the system, main ambit of the country. Apart from elected members, local MLAs and MPs become members of the block samiti and parishads, jila parishads. Also, all the heads of the gram panchayat of a block members of the block samiti. Similarly, all the heads of block samitis of a district become members of the Jila Parishad. These members are called ex-officio members, as they become members because of the office or post they hold. Now, MPs and MLAs who are actually been appointed, who are actually been working, they are given the responsibility to look after whether the district head, that is DM, whether he is performing his duty or not. What is his duty? To look at the Jila level, to look at the district level. Okay. Apart from his own task, he has other responsibility to look at the block and the villages. Whether the video is performing his task or not, whether the plans are implemented or not. The block level and the panchayat level, both at village level, both he has to see. Who? The district head, that is DM. Now, DM is represented by one person, either the MP or MLA. They come into the ambit, they look after the affairs of these people. That is why they are known as ex-officio members. They cannot come on a direct basis. They are not ruling, they are not supervising on a direct basis. But on an indirect basis, they supervise. That is why they are known as ex-officio members. The state government has representatives in all the panchayats. It's the state government which actually declares the responsibility to the different groups, and that is why it has a representative in all the districts, in all the villages, in all the panchayats. It appoints a panchayat secretary to the gram panchayat. Panchayat secretary is appointed at gram panchayat. The block development officer or BDO is the government's representative in the block samiti. At block samiti, BDO is the officer. And an officer of the rank of a district magistrate, district DM or district magistrate, is appointed to the Jila Parishad. These officials ensure the proper functioning of panchayat. The basic work that these people perform, they see that whether the work which is bestowed onto these people are being performed on a smoother basis or not, whether the plans reach to the last person or not. So their task is basically to ease the government step or to implement the plans which are formulated or which are made by the government, so that it can reach to the last person of the society, last person of the country. No person should be left behind, no person should be discriminated on any ground. So the work basically of these people are ease the process of, ease the work of the government officials. Functions and sources of income in the next class, we shall see class. Thank you so much.